Hello again, everybody. It's me, Marcus, and I review stuff. Today, I'm reviewing the song Robots 3 Human Zero by Norma Jean. This does come as a request. As always, if you would like to request something, leave it in the comments. I'll be sure to get to it. What I've done is I've taken every single request I've received on my channel, threw it into this Google Sheet. I hit the randomize button 3 times at the end of every video, and the top result is the very next song I listened to. So that's how we got to this choice here. Stay tuned to the end of the video to see what I listen to next. Now, I've heard one other song by Norma Jean. I believe it was The End of All Things Will Be Televised, which I didn't really care for as much. You know, I could appreciate it on some level, but it just didn't quite stick with me the way I thought it would. So, hoping that this one will kind of turn the page for me on Norma Jean. So, all right, without further ado, let's listen to it. Again, Norma Jean, Robots 3, Humans 0. Let's check it out. And I am using the official music video this time around, so hopefully it's a good one. Here we go. I actually really liked that. If I remember correctly, one thing I said about The End of All Things Will Be Televised was that it was just like unrelenting, and like in a not enjoyable way. It was just so heavy that it was like it really gave you like no room to breathe. It really didn't ever let up, to the point where it was to the song's detriment. Whereas I feel like in this song, it was so much easier to enjoy. Again, it gave you some time to breathe. It gave you some heaviness, with some very nice melody. So I really like this one. I liked it a whole lot. So we're gonna break the song down like we always do, of course, starting with the lyrics. So I have them right here. Robots 3, Human 0. Open that door, I'll follow you into that space there, where nothing is regretted then forgotten. Where is that grace that carries me out? So strange, it's mine. It's closed and locked, but if you open that door, it won't be. So, judging just from like the music video, I'm assuming this is about a breakup, right? Open that door, I'll follow you into that space, where nothing is regretted or then forgotten. Where is the grace that carries me out? So strange, it's mine. It's closed and locked, but if you open that door, it won't be. Yesterday, when before the days of collapsing, and I'll stand through all these lines just to make it back to you. Can you help me every step of the way? Can we bear? We can bury that battle and bury the cause. There is nothing that I can say because I was wrong this time. So maybe I'm reading this from the perspective of someone who wants to kind of give their all to their significant other, but maybe they messed up. They messed up somewhere along the way, and like justifiably, she's upset. But what is going to be done about it? Everyone knows because they see the glare in our eyes. Be careful now, don't drown yourself in sorrow. I was the one that built that cross and weighed you down, and now I'll carry on till it's over, and it's over. So yeah, again, to me, sounds like a relationship where one person just kind of messed up, and the other person is like, I'm out, and basically understanding that this time, this one's on me, And so I still carry these feelings for you, but I kind of ruined it. So that's how I read it. I have no idea how that relates to the title of Robots 3, Human 0. Maybe like he's thinking that if he was more robotic and didn't have these emotions, it would be easier for him. But because he is human, these things do come up. That's my best guess at it. Or the title could just be nonsense. I mean, let's not look too much into it if it's just nonsense. But I think it's I thought it was interesting lyrically. It kept me interesting. Oh, that makes a lot of sense. Here on it says vocals Cove Reber and Chino Moreno. I was just thinking, I was like, that's it sounded to me like so Deftones inspired. I was like, okay, but yeah, that was literally Chino Moreno. Okay, that's great. I like that a lot more now. Maybe that's why I think it had a lot more cadence. It had a lot more melody for me. I think Chino brought a lot to this song. So great. I had no idea. I don't know too much about the Deftones, but from what I have heard from them, I do love their work. So shout out to Chino. But yeah, that was great. So anyway. Not vocally, lyrically, I thought it was a good song. I gave it 2 thumbs up. As far as the instrumentation goes, great drum work. It looks like Chris Raines came in with the drums there at the beginning, and I liked it. I liked what he did there at the start, and then throughout there was some just nice drumming, good high energy. Really couldn't hear too much of the bass. I have a feeling that just because of the age of this video, looks like 2010, the audio quality wasn't great, so couldn't quite bank out the bass there, but I'm sure it was fine. To me, the guitar really did a number here. Corey Brandon, Chris Day, and Scotty Henry looks like fantastic work from them. I think there were some nice riffs in there. They had a couple of nice like little breakdowns. I don't know if that's even what you'd call it, but just some nice moments of heavy guitar with still plenty of melody to go around. Again, I think that's why I like this one a little bit more than the last song I heard from them. There was a lot more melody here versus just sheer sound and noise, I feel like. So, fantastic job on guitars from them. Lead vocals Corey Brandon. I'm assuming he did a lot of the singing. Great job from him too, but Cove Reber and Chino Moreno, I'm wondering what parts they did respectively. I think overall the vocal performance was nice. Yeah, and I was thinking like, well, this vocal performance is very Deftones inspired, and it makes sense now why. I mean, Chino Moreno was attached to it, so that's pretty cool. I had no idea he worked with Norma Jean at all, so pretty neat stuff. I liked it. I thought it was good from an instrumental and a vocal standpoint. Again, it wasn't just unrelentingly heavy. There was some nice moments of breath in there. I give it two thumbs up. And then as far as replay value goes, this one's pretty catchy. I like the song a lot. I mean, it has that sort of hook that just really gets stuck in your head. So I have a feeling I want to listen to this one again pretty soon. So for replay value, I give it two thumbs up. I thought it was great. Overall, really solid suggestion. So this has made me want to give Norma Jean a second chance. After that first song, I was like, I don't know, man. If all the songs are like this, I don't know how I'm gonna feel about it. But after this one, I'm like, okay, let's hear a little bit more from them. I'd be interested to see what else they can do. So overall, a solid request. Thank you for whoever requested this one. If you enjoyed the music as much as I did, go support the artist. Go listen to their music wherever you can. One place you should be able to find the artist and this song is going to be in my Spotify playlist. It's in the description below, as every single song I've heard so far on my channel. If you want to support me, just all the normal stuff you do on YouTube, like and subscribe and comment. All right, before I let you go, help me figure it out. What are we listening to next time? So we are done with this selection. Let's get rid of it. Pass it up. There it is. And let's randomize. Let's figure it out. What are we listening to next? One and two and three. Ooh, some drive-by truckers. I've really enjoyed what I've heard from drive-by truckers, so I'm very much looking forward to this one. So drive-by truckers, Zip City is our next request, and well, I hope to see you in the next one. All right, bye for now.